providing a safe, pakka small house. That is the most important one for a guaranteeing the dignified life for a poor in the village.
अरे भाया गाँव गाँव का हो भाया
वो तो केवल नाडी की मिट्टी होती है हमारे तालाब वगैरह की, वहाँ से मतलब मिट्टी लाके उनसे बनाते थे। बारिश होते ही वो तो फिर गिर जाती थी, फिर नीपना करना वो मतलब होता था, तो उसकी सारी इसके पीछे वो टेंशन खत्म हो गई।
कच्चे में तबीली तो सब और मान दिया जाने पर जल गो गए पका था जले तो नहीं है के नहीं पर कच्चा आवे जाने पर मैं आंधी जोर आवे जब ये बाज उड़ जाए उड़े जाने पर तो जल नहीं जाएगा पर तक भी नहीं जाएगा पर मैं जल गया जाने पर बाहर बैठा मौका कर जाए
हैं कोर कचरो पड़े में रोटी गड़ो तो ही ऊंदरा दलटा कर दे हैं नाड़ में आकर फाइद दो तो नित्रो तो हैं गोर अटियों दूर जाए अटियों दूर जाए
Huts, they don't have windows. So the walls are very small, say 2 feet, 3 feet height like that. You have to bow your head and go inside. And even if you go inside, then it will be dark. The children always, they will not stand even for 10 minutes in the house. Except at the time of sleeping and at the time of eating, they eat. After that, they run out. So when they are not interested in staying in the hut, then where is the chance for reading? Where is the chance for, you know, socializing?
పిల్లలు మేము 8 మంది సభ్యులు ఉన్నాం కాబట్టి ఒక వర్షం వచ్చినా ఇరకాటంగా ఎక్కువ స్థలం తక్కువ ఉండింది మాకు అసలు ఫ్రీగా ఉండేదానికి కూడా స్థలం లేదు అందువల్ల చాలా ఇబ్బందులు పడినాము
పి చంద్రలేలమ్మ ఫ్రమ్ ది విలేజ్ తారిగోట్ల ఇస్ నౌ అ ప్రౌడ్ ఓనర్ ఆఫ్ అ పక్కా హౌస్ జస్ట్ వన్ ఆఫ్ ద మెనీ దట్ హావ్ కమ్ అప్ ఇన్ ద రీజన్ ఓవర్ ద పాస్ట్ ఫ్యూ ఇయర్స్ STC and its partner organizations are working towards making pakka homes possible for rural Indian households in Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Odisha, Kerala, Karnataka, and Rajasthan.
STC in its country program identifies the geographical areas it wants to work in, and these are normally semi-arid regions in the country.
The Kutumbakam effort is totally to demonstrate panchayat as a local self-government. They came forward to help Kutumbakam process because it's a panchayat-led initiative. So here in this case, the panchayat was promoting the housing. You are using the locally available materials like red earth or sand or what is it, locally available material. And the technology is also very simple. The machinery is maximum just 25,000 to 85,000 rupees, the machinery cost. And rest of the thing is people's involvement. Any common man or layman in the village, they can learn the technology in one day, just by mixing. It's all hand mixing and other thing. Operation is purely, it gives opportunity for the people to work. For a small pakka house of say 250 square foot, they need at least 45,000 to 50,000 rupees. You are bringing something like 25,000 rupees support or the entire building material support, then it is possible that by spending 2 years expenses for repairing the hut, it may be 7,000 rupees or 8,000 rupees, that it is convincing them, yes, I will bring that 7,000 rupees or 10,000 rupees as money. And apart from this, I can contribute labor. That gap of 10,000 rupees or 12,000 rupees was the issue.
The government assistance only meets part of the need, and the remaining amount needs to be raised either by the family resources or by finances from the market. Now, that shouldn't be a load on the rural family. So the focus was on developing livelihood options. This happened in many different ways, largely facilitated by the partners. In the area of rural housing, we were really not looking at financing the houses themselves, but we were mainly looking at providing good housing designs, creating options, promoting energy efficient, environment friendly materials, as well as decentralized production methods to enhance the livelihood options.
इधर से हम लोग को अच्छा पगार मिलता है, 2000 रुपये मिलता है महीने में। ये पगार हम लोग लेके जाके महीने में हम लोग को उधर बैंक में भरने के लिए अच्छा लगता है।
The program was not only able to provide rural poor families with improved housing using cost-effective, environmentally friendly materials, but also to provide them with the skills to use such materials. The program as such was anchored in government-sponsored schemes and schemes that were also funded by microfinance institutions, and that enabled the participants to leverage resources from both government and microfinance institutions.
In this rural housing program, JC Max, we are working. In JC Max, having 2,300 women members is there, nearly 70%. They don't have pakka houses. In these 3 years, we constructed 160 pakka houses with the support of JC Max. In Kadapa area, JC Max providing loans with 15% interest. With this Sangams, JCS is giving loan and they are slowly repaying. Basically, in the villages, if we want anybody to construct a house, we sit in the household and design the house. What are their needs? According to their needs, we are planning. And also, we are planning with a lot of women's only. We are planning. We are designing kitchen room, like almara shelves and smokeless. That's chulla. That's we are giving most preference to women.
उन्नति संस्थान जोधपुर में उन्होंने ये हमारे को जगह जगह प्रशिक्षण के रूप में काम सिखाया।
गांव की मिट्टी और गांव के मजदूर और गांव के काम करने वाले कारीगर वगैरह टोटल मतलब पत्थर वगैरह सब के पैसे भी बच जाते हैं और ये होती मजदूर।
One very interesting dimension in this project has been that the different partners from different parts of the country have influenced each other tremendously. Like Ilango's panchayat leadership, encouraging people to work with panchayats, have given other partners a possibility to dream and to realize local housing schemes on a scale which we didn't anticipate would happen.
The challenge is not merely one at the ground level, but also at the policy level. During the course of the projects, SDC and its partners worked to formulate a platform in which such issues could be debated and changes advocated with the appropriate authorities.
The experience that we have made in the rural housing program could very much be of benefit for other countries. I'm thinking in Africa, for example, or some parts of Latin America.